Hi everyone. So today we're going to be reviewing what we know about exponents and then talking about the laws that you learned last year in algebra. And then the next couple of days we're going to be practicing those laws and making sure you feel comfortable with the rules of exponents. But first of all, let's talk about an exponent. You guys are normally used to seeing a number raised to something called an exponent, okay? So we would say that this is 5 to the 2 power, okay? And it means 5 times 5, which is 25. All right, but what you need to know is you need to know what each piece is. This piece, the big number, is called the base, okay? That's the base. So in this case, the base is 5. And the number that it's raised to is called the exponent. That's how many times the base occurs, okay? So the exponent, how many times the base occurs. Now the whole thing together is called a power. So this is 5 to the 2 power, okay? So we call that entire thing a power. Again, the bigger or larger number is the base, the number it's raised to is the exponent, that's how many times it's occurring, and then the whole thing is called a power. All right, so you've learned in previous classes some things with exponents, but I want us to make sure we review them again. You have to be careful with order of operations. For example, negative 3 to the 4 power means negative 1 times 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. That 4 is only being that 3 is only being raised to the 4 power. So you have to really be careful with that negative that's in front of it. I kind of think of it as it's separate union. And that's why I wrote it here as negative 1 for you. So 3 times 3 is 9, 9 times 3 is 27, 27 times 3 is 81. So if I were to evaluate this entire exponent or power, it would be negative 81. All right, now what did I do from A to B? Well, I did now put parentheses around it. That means that negative 3 is being raised to the 4 power. So that means negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3. So a negative times a negative is a positive. A positive times a negative is a negative, and a negative times a negative is a positive. So anytime you raise something to an even power, if it's negative, it's going to turn out to be a positive number. So then this would be positive 81, since we've already done that. Now the last two, I just want us to be really careful because those parentheses do matter. 1 plus 5 squared, I have to follow proper order of operations and do everything within the parentheses before I do anything with the 2 power. So this becomes 6 squared, which is 36. Now look, in the next question, I only raise the 5 to the 2 power. So following order of operations, I actually have to do 5 squared first. You do not add 1 plus 5 and then square it. All right, so this would be 1 plus 25, which is 26. Now they look the same, but look how the result is very different. And that's why always paying close attention to order of operations is going to be important. All right, let's move on. All right, writing things as an exponent. All right, so if I have 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, writing it as an exponent is just an easier way of looking at it. So first we write our base, which would be 2, and then how many times does 2 occur? 1, 2, 3, and 4 times, so 2 to the 4 power. All right, x. X times x times x times x. The base is x. How many times does it occur? It occurs 4 times. All right, I want to point out this one again. We've been talking about this the last couple of days. This is not multiplying exponents. It's adding exponents. So we follow the rules that I talked about with combining like terms. We add the exponent, or we do not add the exponents. We add the numbers, and we keep the exponent the same, okay? So there's 2 x's here, which we add together, but the exponent does not change when we're adding and subtracting. Okay? And again, that's a monomial. All right, these are laws. We're going to talk about the 3 laws of exponents that these 2 sections or 3 sections cover that you did learn last year, and I'm going to use some of my verbiage, okay? So the first law is when we multiply powers with the same base. So in my words, AKA, also known as power times a power. All right, so this is a power and this is a power. The bases are the same, so this can only work when the bases are the same. When it's power times a power, you add the exponent. So this would be b to the x plus y. Power times a power, add them high. Okay, so here we go. We look at our first example. N cubed times n to the fifth. The bases are the same, so it's power times a power, so we add the exponents, and we'll get n to the 8th power. Do I have to show this step? No, you don't. All right, next example, B. Now, I'm going to leave some examples for us to go over and ask over questions in class. But for B, I have x to the 3 times x to the 2 times x to the 1 power. So make sure you know that it has a 1 there. It's hidden, though. All right, power times a power. The bases are the same. We add them high. So x, 3 plus 2 is 5 plus 1 is 6. So that becomes x to the 6th power. That's the power times a power law. Okay? All right. We also have the power raised to a power law. So law 2. Power raised to a power means we have a base that's raised to an exponent that's raised to another exponent in parentheses. Now we have to make sure we understand that exponent on the outside is raising anything in the parentheses to that exponent. Okay? All right, I also call this power to a power, meaning power raised to a power. When we raise something to a power, we multiply. So power to a power, multiply. So b to the x1. All right, let's look at some examples of that. N cubed to the 5th power. Power to a power, we multiply. So it would be 3 times 5, which is 15, okay? Looking at B, I put stars here because it's a little bit trickier. You need to understand that 3 is cubing the 2 and cubing the x. It belongs, we multiply it to both powers. 2 has a little power of 1 and x has a little power of 1. So both of them have to be multiplied, okay? So we get 2 to the 3 power, x to the 3 power. Now we would never leave 2 to the 3 power if it is something you know how to evaluate. So 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8. So that would give me 8x to the 3 power. So power to a power, we multiply the exponents. Never want to forget that that exponent belongs to everything within the parentheses. All right, last one. Dividing powers with the same base, okay? All right, so the bases are the same, indicated by the B, and they have different exponents. So when it's powers with the same base, you subtract the exponents. So you bring, I always say you bring the smaller to the larger and you subtract. So this would become b to the x minus y. All right, now we gotta be careful because we always wanna have a positive number as our exponent, always. So I always tell students, just like I did when we were balancing equations, bring the smaller exponent to the larger and subtract them. And I'll show you what I mean. Okay, so I look here, x to the 6th over x squared, the bases are the same, so I'm gonna subtract the exponents. But which exponents do I subtract and where? So here's a 2. I'm gonna bring that smaller one up to the 6th and subtract, so now I'm gonna be in the numerator. So x to the 6 minus 2. Which is x to the 4. Now that's in the numerator. When we brought that 2 up, it kind of went away. The reason that is true, guys, is because if I wrote this as x 6 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all over 2 times, well, wouldn't these 2 cancel? And wouldn't I be left with 4 x's, so x to the 4 power? That's why this law works. But here's a really good example of why I want you to bring the smaller to the larger. If you bring the smaller to the larger, you'll always get a positive exponent. So 4 is smaller, but it's in the numerator. So I'm going to bring it down to the denominator, but I have to leave a placeholder in the numerator. So I'm going to bring the 4 to the 7 and write it as 1 all over y to the 7 minus 4. So it's 1 all over y cubed. Why do I have to put a placeholder there? Because it's in the numerator, and you can't just disappear, you can't just get rid of numerators, okay? So again, as a quick recap of the video, we did power times the power, add them high, power to a power, multiply, power divided by a power, bring the smaller to the larger and subtract the exponents, so x squared. All right, so tomorrow we're going to review this. We're going to practice for several days to make sure you got it. I hope you had a great night. I really think you should probably watch the video now that you've taken your notes one more time. Have a great night. Bye.